Today is Cliff Kincaid with Accuracy and Media to tell us how the demise of our country was toasted not only by the G20 leaders, but by our own president, G.W. Bush himself. Cliff Kincaid, welcome back to the Savage Nation.
Michael, thanks for having me on the show again.
In your recent article, you talk of the global socialist toasting victory over America. What do you mean by that?
America has been cut down to size economically. Welcome to the new global order. It has finally arrived. I thought they would wait until President Obama took office, but no, they've accomplished this under the, quote, conservative Republican presidency of George W. Bush, whose legacy, if you can call it that, will be socialism. And this is not only at home in terms of the bailout of Wall Street and the takeover of our financial institutions by the federal government, but globally, internationally. And what I was focusing on was the November 15th International Summit here in Washington, D.C., where we had the leaders of what are called the G20 countries, including the president of Communist China and the king of Saudi Arabia, coming to town to be toasted by President Bush, in enjoying a sumptuous feast, a rack of lamb, $300 a bottle of wine, but really they were toasting the decline of the United States, the delegation of the United States into second or third rate status internationally. That's what's happening here, and I'm afraid it has set the stage perfectly for President Obama, with his background of revolutionary Marxism, to take full advantage of it.
Rack of lamb feasts and $300 bottles of wine. Where is the outrage over this?
Well, I'm starting to hear from a lot of people who are outraged. I know I'm outraged. Michael, I've been here in Washington for 30 years. I came up to Washington, D.C. in the summer of 1978. That's when I got my first job at Accuracy and Media from Ames founder Reed Irvine. I've been through a lot. I was here cheering on the Reagan administration and the battle against communism in Central America. We, of course, eventually saw Soviet-style communism decline. But now, strangely, we're seeing the victory of socialism in the United States. I never thought we would come to this point. And that's why I'm outraged. I'm angry. And I'm hearing from a lot of people who are not only angry over seeing their stocks decline and losing their jobs, but over what's happened to the great, once great, United States. Here's one email I got from somebody in response to the AIM article at AIM.org that you mentioned. He said it this way. He said, I just finished reading the menu. He's referring to the menu for the G20 November 15th summit here in Washington, D.C. I've just finished reading the menu that I and the U.S. taxpayers just bought these idiots and thieves. $300 bottles of wine, racks of lamb. And he says, does the image of Nero fiddling while Rome burns come to mind?
Exactly.
And he goes on to say, what if Bush had just announced that the menu was going to reflect the seriousness of the situation? Maybe a good minestrone soup and some good Carlo Rossi Red. Well, I found out Carlo Rossi Red sells for about $6.99 a bottle. But of course, that's not good enough for the global elite who were really here on the 15th toasting the decline of the United States. And I might add at that point, Michael, it's not just an economic decline. This is going to have tremendous repercussions militarily. Because look, if the United States cannot remain as a superpower economically and financially, our military power is going to decline. I mean, if we can't even maintain an auto industry, if we can't even build cars, then how are we going to build any weapons of war to defend ourselves in the future? And this is why I say it sets the stage perfectly for President Obama, because all along, we know that his intention has been to turn our security and safety over to the United Nations. And maybe, I guess, the European nations are going to help protect us, or maybe we'll somehow continue to exist under the umbrella of Communist China. This is why I'm angry. Because if you examine what's happening to this country, it's the end of America as we know it. And this guy who sent me the email, he's talking about a company he runs, and he says, personally, I resent more and more everyone associated with my government, and especially the country club Republicans. And he refers to Bush and Treasury Secretary Paulson. He goes on, I may have to lay off two good guys this coming week. I'm sure they will understand that the president had to keep up the image to all these important people in Washington who came here for the summit, the king of Saudi Arabia, the Chinese president, Hu Jintao, who enjoyed all this largesse, the $300 bottle of wine, and so forth and so on. Yeah, I'm hearing a lot from people who are angry, and they should be angry. I mean, I've been not only hearing from people, but I was watching a C-SPAN show the other day where, of course, they take calls from people, and they were discussing the financial meltdown with some so-called expert, and people were calling in just angry as hell. People are losing their jobs, they're losing their homes, the value of their stocks is declining, the value of their homes is declining, and yet we've got politicians, not only from the United States, but globally here in Washington, drinking $300 a bottle of wine.
You wrote that in the declaration that Bush endorsed at this summit, there was support for the UN's Millennium Development Goals. What?
People have to understand that the looting of the American taxpayers is not over. And I'm not just talking about the proposed $25 billion bailout of the auto industry. That's peanuts. That's chicken feed. That's chicken feed compared to the $700 billion for Wall Street. That's chicken feed compared to what Federal Reserve Board Chairman Ben Bernanke says is $2 trillion. That's $2 trillion in emergency loans that the Fed has given to domestic and foreign banks. And that's right, foreign banks. Hundreds of billions of dollars have been extended in, quote, emergency loans from the U.S. taxpayer to the Federal Reserve to banks all over the world. But that's not it, because what the international elite did in that declaration on November 15th was commit, and Bush went along with this, to even more foreign aid spending on the rest of the world at the expense of the American taxpayers. And again, this sets the stage perfectly for President-elect Obama, because we had talked before about his so-called Global Poverty Act. And what this International Summit Declaration does is set the stage for that to be passed either in a lame duck session of Congress or through a new Congress under a new administration. And the Global Poverty Act, which is envisioned in this summit declaration, commits the United States to spending 0.7% of our gross national product on foreign aid. And I won't bore you with all the details, but I've been to all these UN conferences, I've studied the documents, and what that means is, by their own admission, that commits the United States to spending another $845 billion on foreign aid for the rest of the world, not for us, for the rest of the world. And then on top of that, Obama also supports something called the Jubilee Act. This wasn't explicitly referred to in the summit declaration, but it's part of the puzzle, part of the whole ball of wax. That would cancel the debts of foreign countries to the tune of $75 billion. So you add these two bills up, these two measures, you get $920 billion, with a B, $920 billion, on top of the $2 trillion, on top of the $700 billion. And we're getting to a point where I saw a European financial newsletter today, which I trust, which had predicted the current financial crisis, saying that the United States is approaching national bankruptcy. National bankruptcy, that they predict in the new year that the United States will effectively go bankrupt. We will start defaulting on our debt. So this process is going to continue. It's going to get worse. And I suppose eventually, like Iceland, which went bankrupt this year, maybe the United States will eventually have to go hat in hand to the International Monetary Fund and the World Bank for financial support, not to mention the Chinese. Hopefully they'll give us some more money, and the rich Arab states that will have to beg for some dollars for them, just like Bush was toasting the King of Saudi Arabia on November 15th. This should make anybody outraged in the United States that we've gotten to this point where we're a bankrupt nation and now we're being cut down to size by the rest of the world as part of this new world order in which the United States is really just going to become a bit player in a new order dominated by the Europeans, Chinese, and the rich Arabs.
Cliff Kincaid, thanks for being on the Savage Nation.
Michael, it's been great to be with you. Thanks a million.
Savage.